this episode of Kitchen Bitch. Where's my theme music, bitch? So on this episode of Kitchen Bitch, I'll be wrapping steaks with turkey bacon, lemon peppered shrimp with a side dish of mashed cauliflower for my roommate. Mashed cauliflower is a great idea for people on the South Beach diet or even Atkins diet. I believe it works on all phases of South Beach, as well as anything to do with Atkins. Mashed cauliflower is a very good substitute for mashed potatoes. I haven't tried it. I can make it. Just the idea of mashed cauliflower, isn't that great for me? My roommate, Amy, loves it. Instant mashed potatoes, because I'm lazy and cheap like that. And I have some red and green bell peppers that I'll use for something. So let's begin! For the steaks wrapped in turkey bacon, we will need, of course, some turkey bacon. I have right here. We'll need some steaks, fairly well. I'm going to do something with some bell peppers in there somewhere, because they're just so pretty. And then various spices that I'll add later. For our mashed cauliflower, we'll need cauliflower and some other stuff. It just takes a while to steam this, and the whole process goes along very quickly. For our shrimp, our lemon pepper shrimp kebabs, we need some shrimp, which I have just thawed. Need some lemons for the lemon pepper part. And in here I have two skewers that are soaking in water so that they don't overheat or anything. I do all of my cooking on cast iron. The lemon pepper shrimp kebabs will be on my cast iron flat skillet. And then my steaks I will be doing in my cast iron skillet here. Be doing the mashed cauliflower in a steamer here, and then the simple mashed potatoes will be done from a mashed potato box. First thing we'll need to do is preset our oven to 400 and something degrees. I'm going to go about there. It says 425-ish. The thing we'll do is take a cutting board, of course, and take our steaks. And we're not going to do anything to them yet, because you know what I forgot to do? I've already forgot to preheat all my pan, because it's cast iron and it takes a little while to heat up. I always put them on what my stovetop says is 4, but it's because it goes through 6.5, which is just really weird, 6 to high, so it's 7, so the scaling is just really weird. So with the steaks, what we'll do, we'll go ahead and take them out. See, what I did originally was I bought a pack of 2 steaks that were actually quite large steaks. And then I cut them down in half, so I had 4 steaks. So it's like so much easier. And I'll trim off the excess fat here. And just go ahead throw that away. Fan the heat up nicely. And I like to put extra virgin olive oil in there. And what I do, I've put my extra virgin olive oil inside of this tequila bottle, the quick pour, so it's easy to come out. Now we'll take a couple of slices of turkey bacon, or 4 slices of turkey bacon to be precise, because I just feel like doing 4, because 4 is a big number. And I'm going to close it back up and stick it in the fridge. Now, one of the things that I really like to do is use cooking twine. It's very easy. I like it because it holds everything together. And it's not as much hassle as using toothpicks or anything like that that you're just going to find because you might forget it. This, you can easily see. I like to have a whole bunch already pre-cut. So what we're going to do, we'll take some turkey bacon, wrap it halfway around that way, wrap it halfway around the other way, kind of smush it together, and then take your twine to help hold your bacon on. And just tie it like you're tying your shoes. Hopefully, that'll hold. Not that you can even see what I've done so far because of the fucked up camera angle, but we'll try it one more time, and we'll see.
under. And go over.
And we've wrapped our steaks in bacon. Now for lemon, pepper, shrimp kebabs. You do, take a lemon, you roll it. By rolling it, what you're doing is you're breaking up all that stuff inside. And it's going to make it easier to squeeze. And we're going to take our shrimp, we're going to marinate it for a little while in lemon and some pepper. How simple is that? What we need, just a small cutting board. That lemon's getting rolled, and we'll roll this one as well. So if you're picking out lemons, you want to make sure you have good strong ones that you can actually do this with. You don't want a soft one. And either somebody's already rolled it or it's already gone bad. Take it, cut it in half, and squeeze. Now, fresh cracked pepper, because you have not lived until you've had fresh cracked pepper. And move it around. You want everything to have some lemon, have some pepper. It smells wonderful. Just the only other thing I cut on this cutting board is lemon. It's perfectly safe to cut bell peppers on. And then, this is green. It'll be a fun thing. I'm kind of doing large chunks right now because it's what I want. If you want small chunks, do small chunks. Small chunks, that's a size 6.5 chunk Taylor. The next thing that's also going to take quite a while to cook is our cauliflower. Because cauliflower takes a little bit more time, especially frozen cauliflower. So I'm going to go ahead and turn on the pot and get this going. I do about half a bag or so. I'll cook the rest in the future. Move the bell peppers off the way. So you can see what I'm going to do to these two steaks. I'm going to take some black pepper. Take it on over there. Take it, flip it. Some salt. And I'm just a really big fan of garlic powder. That's just the way that I am. If you don't like garlic powder, then don't put garlic powder on it. Come over. There we go. One of the most important things about cooking is timing. So if you can't time all your stuff to go together, then you're kind of screwed. It takes less time to cook shrimp than it does to cook steak. It's a simple fact. So what I'm going to do, we're going to go ahead and we're going to sear the steak on either side, try and get the bacon seared some, and then take the whole thing and shove it in the oven and let it cook through the rest of the way. I like my steak medium rare. That's just me. Whatever you like. But if you want to wait 5 days for a steak to have it well done, go ahead and wait 5 days to have the steak well done. But usually through this method, it all kind of, all the pink usually gets cooked out, but it's still a very tender steak because you sear it first. It's interesting. I don't know how it works. Food works in mysterious ways. I'm not a chef or anything like that. I'm just the kitchen bitch. Thank you. We got this here right now. We'll go ahead and take this cutting board, stick it in the sink. Clean it up later. Let it sear a little bit on either side, and we'll be good to go. So what I'm doing right now, holding the steak on the bacon side, try and help it sear a little bit better. Now that it's seared, we're going to go ahead and stick it in the oven. My bell peppers. Now that all that's in the oven, I'm going to go ahead and get the shrimp kebab ready now. Pull out yet another flexible cutting board. And I've chosen to do 10 shrimp on each skewer. Then we just take the shrimp, stick it on the skewer. Yeah, I'm filming. Come say hi to everybody, Amy. Amy, come say hi. Amy's shy right now.
You mounted up there.
I used clamps. I'm so ingenuous.
What happened?
What do you mean what happened?
Why is it so cute?
Because I don't have the vent on because then they couldn't hear me.
Oh. You're so clever.
Sometimes. You sure you want to come say hi to everybody? I've been talking about you.
Have you? What
yeah. Is that how you want to have the mashed cauliflower because it's on the South Beach diet and it's good for you? Now we're going to go ahead and do the skewers. And as soon as they hit there, they're going to be smoking and cooking and popping. Got to get some quick flavor on there. Do some pepper. Do a little salt. In a second, they'll already be kind of turn. Well, it's done there. We're going to go ahead and add some more lemon juice. Just to punch it up just a little bit more. They're almost done already. Now, the reason why I went ahead and put them on the skewers is because they're just so much easier to turn and cook that way. You can do them loose if you want to and just toss them on the pan on your serving plate, which is most likely what I'll end up doing anyway. I went ahead and got out of the plate so that once those are done cooking, I can set them aside while I finish the rest of the dinner. Now, while this is finishing up, we're going to go ahead and start our mashed cauliflower. Cauliflower. I'm gonna add some smart balance. This, I don't even know how much I'm adding, I'm just putting it in. Until it looks like it's about right. If you like more butter, go ahead and put more butter in. I put some sour cream. I can find out how I opened it last time.
Cream cheese.
Sorry, cream cheese, I messed up. I am known to make mistakes with cheese. Like this one? It hasn't been opened yet. This one, on the other hand, has been opened. Always use what you've already used. Or, actually, to correct that, use what you've already opened.
up, put it back in this little house, get back in the fridge. Now, good?
1 tablespoon. That would be that.
1 tablespoon, she said.
We were trying something new.
Because it is something new that we are trying. You can probably hear her off camera, she's too afraid. She'll go in front of hundreds of people and sing her songs, but she won't want to come on camera to say hi to YouTube. Now we salt and pepper. And we're going to toss some garlic in it this time. We didn't do that last time. How about that? Now, we match. Cover your ears. Now it looks just like mashed potatoes. Now while this was going, I went ahead and pulled off the skewers. Go ahead and take this off. We have one of these neat ones that's a blender and a food processor. You just gotta take off the top. Now I can store it right there. And now we're gonna look at our steaks. Let this go for just one more minute so I can go ahead and make my instant mashed potatoes. We're using cream cheese versus yogurt.
Or sour cream, but you can use yogurt or sour
cream. Or sour cream. So we're using cream cheese instead of yogurt or sour cream because of the consistency. You can use it if you choose to. It's just going to be a little bit thinner and runnier. Now, I can say, yes, I am a small guy. But yes, I eat a lot. So, I make 2 servings worth of mashed potatoes, just for me. Now, I could follow the instructions on the box completely, but that's just not fun for me. So, I know I need 2/3 cups of water, to 2/3 cups of flakes, and 1/4 cup of milk. But everything else is kind of up to you. Put in some smart balance. Go ahead and stick it on the back there. Start to let it go. Some pepper, lots of pepper, it actually gives it some flavor. Salt, maybe some seasoned salt just for fun. And I'm going to go with some garlic and some oregano. Because garlic just makes everything taste better. And oregano, that's less of it than I had. And this time, I'm going to add a little bit of sage. Not too sure why, but that's a great spice. Smell. Yeah, it is that good. Go ahead and pre-measure out my 2/3 cups of flakes. Take it down. And pull out my milk. Now we do a little dance while waiting for the water to boil. Get a song so I can shake my ass to it. The water. Boil for your mashed potatoes. Yes, I am teaching them how to make instant mashed potatoes.
Ah.
Yeah. My way. This actually tastes halfway decent. your mashed potatoes that are infant aren't going to be consistency that you would like, just add some more flakes or more milk. Delicious. Now, our steak should be about done.
That is beautiful.
There, yeah, look at that. You want some of that, don't you? Yeah, come get it, bitch. Now for the plating. This is my plate, because it's the big steak.
I want lots of red peppers.
One of the reasons why you tied the string like your shoes, so you can untie these. That's one key thing to remember if you're cooking for two people on two different diets. You don't want to mix stuff up so that somebody gets off your diet and gets all pissy. Not that Amy gets pissy, I'm just saying you don't want your friend to get pissy at you, and then they'll take their spoon towel and beat you upside the head for making the wrong thing.
There was just that one time.
I'm not talking about that one time. I'm talking to the good people out there, the YouTubians. They're watching this in their kitchen going, how the fuck do I make what he just made? It looks beautiful and it tastes wonderful. So now we're gonna...
Wait, they don't know how it tastes.
Well, I do.
Are you going to invent taste-o-vision?
I already invented smell-o-vision with the sage.
No, someone else already invented smell-o-vision.
So I'm gonna invent a fax machine so I can fax everybody some food. Here's Amy's plate. We have the mashed cauliflower, the shrimp kebab, steak wrapped in bacon, and some peppers. My plate. Mashed potatoes, shrimp kebab, bell peppers, there, and my steak. And there you go.
Now we're gonna enjoy our dinner.
What'd you think of the delicious meal that I deliciously had made and slaved over the stove for you?
I think it's absolutely delicious. No, I really liked it. You did really well with the mashed cauliflower. The consistency was really great. The seasoning on the steak was excellent.
So simple yet effective.
The turkey bacon, I always love turkey bacon, so that wrapped around the beef was great. We had everything that you need for a balanced meal, so that was good, especially for my diet, which is basically just eating healthy.
Yeah.
The shrimp was, I wish that I wasn't completely full because I would totally eat that extra skewer of shrimp. So overall, I give it 3 out of 4.
Good dinner, good food, good people. Always here at
Kitchen Bake.
Now she gets to clean up until I cook.